everyone. So the first thing you want to do is apply a protective base around the perimeter of your head. If you don't have one, you can use Vaseline. This just prevents any hair dye or perm from touching your skin. This is the hair dye I decided to use. It's Luster's 3-in-1 Color Relaxer. It comes with hair dye and the perm and the neutralizing shampoo with color alarm and conditioner, and it had a protective base with it, but I didn't realize that until after I opened the package, but it's all good. What really attracted me to this product is the fact that it came with hair dye. I already dye my hair jet black when I do the pixie cuts because I like it to be that black short color. But I'm just adding a little bit extra of my own personal black hair dye along with the hair dye that they provided just to have a darker color. So you just kind of mix and follow the directions. So at this point in time, I'm just going to apply the product starting from the back of my head. I was at first using the wooden stick that came with it, but then I was just like, I'm just going to use my hands. But start from the back and work your way up. So even though I had the protective base around the perimeter of my head, I still managed to get some product on my skin, on my ear, so I'm just wiping that off with some toilet paper. But if you notice any burning or tingling, of course, you better use some water and soap or something, get that product off. But I'm just finalizing some touches, making sure even my flyaways get the product, because I want us our hair to be completely laid and slayed, honey. As the product states, if you have fine hair, medium hair, coarse hair, depending on what you have, it's a certain amount of time that you should leave the product on. I personally left mine on there for 21 minutes. And I am gonna go to the sink and rinse my hair out with warm water. While I'm in the sink, I will be washing my hair with that neutralizing shampoo that came with the product, just to make sure all of the product completely removes from my hair. All right, we're back from rinsing our hair out. During this time, I'm just gonna focus on applying some conditioner and tea tree oil to my hair and scalp. Thank you. supplied, I'm gonna put a plastic bag over my head and leave it on there for a good 45 minutes to an hour. Make sure my hair is nice and moisturized. Back again, did you miss me? At this time, I'm just gonna comb through my hair, make sure all the product is evenly distributed, and we're gonna get ready for styling very shortly. So now we're getting to the wrapping part. Before I do anything, I'm gonna apply some more tea tree oil on my hair, make sure it moisturizes my scalp. And then I'm gonna apply my foam all around my hair. I'm showing you guys I have my wrap set and my hair set thingy-ma-bobber. But just watch. And at this point, you're just gonna kind of apply everything to your hair and mold it how you would like it to set. I personally like for my pixies to have some curl and body to it, but I like it to lay kind of sideways. So this is why I'm molding my hair kind of like this, whatever floats your boat. But with that foam, it literally helps you create that look that you're wanting once it sets. About y'all, but these were a struggle. But you're gonna apply your wrap set here. Once these apply, it's gonna make sure it lays your hair flat while the mousse is setting. Okay, so you can see I was really struggling with these, but we got it on there. The next thing I have is another wrap set, but it has Velcro. Very helpful with the laying process as well, and I like to finish off with a silk head wrap so it can lay flat, be shiny, and have that silky effect once I'm done. See you guys in about 2 hours. So we're about done. It's been about 2 hours. I'm just unfolding and revealing everything. So I'm just gonna let you guys watch kind of how I style it in the end and leave it at that. Applying my heat protectant. I do have a flat iron that goes to 350 degrees Fahrenheit, but I do not use it that high on my hair. I'm focusing on protecting my hair from as much heat as possible, so this is the lowest possible heat setting. Make sure you have at least a half an inch curling pin or flat iron. I like to use a curling pin because, like I said, I like to have that curl effect. But at this point, y'all, I'm just going to let you guys watch and learn about how I style it. Thank you. That's it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Leave a comment what you think. Make sure you subscribe for more videos. And don't forget to like the video.